Did you know that induction motor accounts to 60 to 70% of the total electric energy consumed in industrial application? And the lifetime of the motor can exceed 20 years with proper maintenance. If this device fails, it causes a huge breakdown on the shop floor where you can lose production, deadlines, money, and your peace, of course. So we have to take utmost care of this industrial motor, but the question is how? You might be aware of the concept of predictive maintenance. Predictive maintenance allows you to predict future failures by learning the current and the past behavior of the motor. To study the behavior of the motor, the simplest way is to attach some sensors to it, like vibration or temperature sensor. And then by carefully examining the data from the sensor, we can detect anomalies, drifts, and forecast the behavior of the motor. The question is, what is anomaly? Anomalies are sudden and unexpected change in the system or change in the motor vibration data, which could be because of vibration spikes, bearing failure, imbalances, or some loose components. Whereas drifts are slow and gradual change in the motor vibration. Gradual change can also be because of wear and tear, slight misalignment, or just like aging of the component. Now the goal is to quickly react to this issue. And there are several stages involved first to find these issues. It starts with data collection, then integrating it with the edge device, or then pre-process this data and then sending it to a machine learning algorithms to find out these metrics. If all of these sounds pretty complicated to achieve, I introduce you WAGO Library Analytics. Using WAGO Library Analytics, you can directly read the vibration data from your PLC program and detect anomalies, drifts, and even forecast your motor behavior. And on top of that, you can also visualize the data and even integrate your pre-trained machine learning models in your system. In this video, I'm going to introduce you this tool with live data coming from my motor. Are you ready? So let's get started. For this video, I am using several hardware and software tools, starting with PFC200, which is loaded with WAGO Library Analytics based on CodeSys. This PFC200 is getting the vibration data from my industrial motor, which is equipped with a vibration sensor via an I/O link master. The vibration data is being sent to WAGO Edge Computer, which is preloaded with machine learning models running on the Docker containers. These machine learning models can be installed on the Edge computer using a single setup file. These machine learning models analyze the data and send results back to PFC200 to trigger alarms or to display data on the web visu. Furthermore, you can also visualize the data on tools like Grafana or Node-RED, which are preloaded on the Edge computer. All the Docker containers are part of this amazing WAGO Library Analytics. So if you are a CodeSys programmer, you do not have to worry about creating machine learning algorithms. Just program the PLC and rest everything is taken care of by the WAGO Library Analytics. So here is my lab setup where you can see the same devices. I am just using a variable frequency drive to control the speed of my induction motor. So let's understand the first use case, which is detecting the anomaly score of a motor's vibration data. The anomaly score is a value between 0 and 1 that indicates behavior resulting from an unexpected and sudden change, where 1 represents the worst behavior and 0 represents the safest behavior. You just need to connect the motor vibration data to the function block of the anomaly detection, which will automatically send it to the specific Docker container to generate an anomaly score. And after defining the threshold, you can detect an incoming anomaly. Let's have a live example. What you see here is a beautifully designed web visu, which also comes with WAGO Library Analytics. Here you can see the live vibration and temperature values of my induction motor. This list shows the Docker containers that are running on the Edge computer. You can view the status of your container along with their port numbers. On the left, we have several buttons for performing analytical functions, as well as some numeric fields to visualize analytical parameters. On the bottom right, there is an XY chart for viewing time series forecast data of my induction motor. To start with anomaly detection, I just have to enable it using this button. This will begin pushing the motor vibration data values to the Docker container responsible for anomaly detection. The threshold is set to 0.25 by default, and we can see an anomaly has already been detected because the anomaly score is higher than the threshold. Let me change that to 0.4 and reset the anomaly. Now you can see the anomaly score is below the threshold. Let me introduce some sudden change in the motor, which I can do by holding the shaft to introduce some vibrations. You can also observe the changes in vibration data on the graph. There we go, the anomaly score was higher than the threshold, and hence we have an indication again.
I can reset the anomaly using this button again. So let's see what is happening in the PLC program. In this program, I am using various function blocks from WAGO Library Analytics. You just have to create an instance of the function block and define some parameters. In this window, I have declared all the variables and instances that I am using in the main logic. These are the various analytics instances that are defined here. Here, I have defined some arrays with string data type for sending the vibration values to the Docker containers. These are the Boolean variables that will enable the data sharing between PFC 200 and the Docker containers running on the edge computer. Additionally, I have declared some other variables required for the analytics functions. In the beginning of the main logic, this block is for reading values from the vibration sensor. Let's go online and read real data. In this block, I am storing the vibration, temperature, and anomaly score as string data types in the array. If we move down, I can show you my anomaly function block. This block is set to true as we enabled it from the WebVisu. Here we have the publish and subscribe time set to 200 milliseconds. This means the PFC 200 is sending values to the Docker container every 200 milliseconds and receives back the anomaly score every 200 milliseconds. This is the array of string, which is basically velocity RMS in X, Y, and Z axis. I also send minimum and maximum limits of the velocity RMS. We can also monitor these values in our variable declaration. The default minimum value is 0 and maximum is 10. In the instance of the anomaly function block, I can also show you the anomaly score coming back from the Docker container. To know more about this function block, just double-click on that, and here you can see our function block description where you can find information about various inputs and outputs ports. Here's another important parameter called T window size, which is by default set to 10 seconds. This means the anomaly score will be calculated from the values recorded in the last 10 seconds. So this was the first use case where we can calculate anomaly score just by sending our modus vibration data to the Docker container. You can realize that you do not have to do much besides defining the parameters. Isn't that super easy to get the anomaly score? I bet it is. So let's disable the anomaly function block and move to the next use case. Now we will detect the drift of the motor, which indicates a slow and gradual change in the motor's vibrations over time. This could be an indication of wear and tear or slowly developing faults. Let's enable the drift detection from this button, and it will start sending motor vibration values to the Docker container responsible for calculating the drift value. At the moment, the drift value is close to zero. Let me introduce some gradual changes in the motor vibration by increasing the motor speed via the variable frequency drive, which is hidden underneath the motor. You can see that with the increase in the motor speed, the vibrations are increasing, and hence the drift value. And with the decrease in motor speed, the vibrations are decreasing, and also the drift value. So you can imagine how the slow and gradual change reflect the drift value. You have to do absolutely nothing. The Docker containers does all the magic to give you the drift value. So let's see how we are getting the drift value in the PLC program. In this block, I am sending VRMS as string data type only for the X axis. The publish and subscribe time is set to 100 milliseconds and a window size to 7 seconds. The window size is the time for which the motor is being observed for drift calculation. This is just the test value. Generally, the window size is in hours, days, weeks, or even months for long-term analysis. Or this interval can also be aligned with your maintenance schedules. The significance level, which is set to 0.02, is a statistical measure that indicates how confident we are that a given drift is not due to random variation. Similarly, you can learn more about these function block parameters with the provided documentation. So, this was how we can calculate the drift of the motor. Let's move on to the next use case. In this use case, I'm going to show you the prediction of future data points. The future data points are generated after learning the short and long-term behavior of motor vibration. In this way, it is possible to detect critical values early. Let's enable the forecast. This will send the motor vibration data to the Docker container responsible for predicting future values. There you go. Now we can see the future predictions on this graph. The blue line represents the input value to the Docker container, and the green line represents the future prediction. You can notice how close the prediction is to the real value. This is achieved using the time series function block, which starts the specific Docker container on the edge device. So in the PLC program, I'm sending only the velocity RMS for the x-axis with my default publishing and subscription time. The input width is 5, which is the number of data points used to make a prediction. The output width is 10, which defines the number of data points predicted. Thus, 5 data points are used to predict 10 data points in the future. After analysis, the function block returns the predictions as an array with the associated timestamp. More information about this functional block parameters can be found in the documentation. So you can imagine how you can easily schedule your upcoming maintenance. Now, on my web visualization, you might have noticed two more buttons. One is for Grafana and another is for Node-RED. These two services are also running on Docker containers inside the Edge computer. By enabling Grafana, the respective function block receives the motor's vibration, temperature, and anomaly score as field values and field names. You can also monitor that over here. These values are essentially going to the influx database, which is further connected to Grafana to show a time series representation. So let's see our Grafana dashboard, which is running on the port 8086. Here you can see all the values which were pushed to the function block are being displayed here. The Grafana container is pre-configured with graphs, so you can just start the container and feed the vibration values and field names. The data will be shown in the Grafana by itself. Isn't that super easy? Similarly, by enabling the Node-RED service on the Docker container, I can also send data directly to Node-RED. Here, I'm sending only the vibration value on the y-axis. You can view this value using a debug node. The data comes in as a JSON string. Just as an example, I'm extracting the value and sending it back to the controller. So my vibration value is coming as JSON string, which you can see in the debug window. I'm formatting it in the function node and sending it back to the controller as a number. You can see the value coming back to the function block here. If you are familiar with Node-RED, you can imagine the endless possibilities for using the data. One realistic example could be sending your analytical data to cloud services for remote monitoring. Furthermore, you have a function block to execute custom Python scripts on your data. You can imagine by integrating Python, you can further process the data and apply custom machine learning algorithm for predictive maintenance or fault diagnostics. Talking about machine learning algorithms, if you already have your own machine learning models, you can integrate that as well using ONNSX function block. This enables you to run your ONNX models by simply sending the motor's vibration data to receive the motor's health status. I can also show you Portainer running on the Edge computer. Portainer is a container management software where you can see the status of your Docker containers and a list of available images.
This brings me to the end of the video. If you're interested to check out this amazing out-of-the-box solution, you can visit the link mentioned in the video description. So thank you for watching this video. I hope you learn about predictive maintenance, important parameters, and how to easily deploy machine learning models using WAGO Library Analytics. But don't go now. You have to click on the like, subscribe, and feel free to share it with your network. See you until next time. Bye-bye.